breadboard. It's been around for a while. It's very useful for prototyping things because you can just like stuff components into the interjoined, interconnected strips. And the normal situation with breadboard is that you have vertical rows of fives interconnected, and then busbar strips along the end which are connected the full length. As shown here by the red line, the blue line, another red line, another blue line, so they're all interconnected. Except this one came from China via eBay, and I was testing a circuit on it, and I put the power at the end and put the circuitry in the middle, and some of the circuitry was working and some of it wasn't, and I just couldn't quite get it to work and couldn't work out what was happening until I started testing for voltages on the board. And I discovered that this is special breadboard from China. Because, as is the usual construction of these, it's a sticky pad that holds all these contacts in. And instead of the bus bars all the way along the back, they've got short sections of four sections of five and three at the end, and breaks in them, so it's not continuous all the way along. And I don't know why they did that. There's a possibility that they found that the strips they'd manufactured weren't the right size and they had to cut them to actually make them fit in, or maybe they were just using offcuts. But I'm going to have to mark this now. I could actually solder wires across the back of that. That might actually be a better idea. I don't want particularly to melt the board. I might actually solder some wires across the back, so it's more useful that way. The other option is just to put little links across, but how annoying is that? I've never come across that before. It's another Chinese eBay special.